Hey, so Azure Advisor gives me personalized recommendations based on a well-architected framework so I can better use my cloud resources. Why don't we take a look? So let's go to Advisor, right over here. And I'm going to click on All Recommendations. This Advisor recommendation says, enable virtual machine backup to protect your data from corruption and accidental deletion. I wonder what that means. I wish I could go to some sort of like Azure Advisor Clinic. Hey, wait, maybe I can. Well, let's bring in an expert. I happen to have here Travis Maier, Supportability PM from Compute. Hey, Travis, I'm wondering if you can help me understand what this recommendation is trying to tell me.
Absolutely, David. Yeah, thanks for reaching out. So I think maybe the first way to start out is just saying, I think it's pretty obvious that data protection is top of mind for any organization right now. Many of our customers have, you know, very strict retention policies on data, and we're all familiar with some of the recent news events about data loss, right? So Azure has built in data loss protection into the Azure platform, and maybe the best way to start here is just to take a look at the actual recommendation that we're showing customers. So now that we're actually looking at the individual recommendation for backup, what you'll see here is that it gives some pretty basic instructions. There aren't many steps in this process, but there are two different ways that we'll review as far as applying a backup policy. So the refresh interval, as you see here, is every 30 minutes. We have this selected as a low priority, just to make individual customers aware that backup is not enabled on these machines. When it comes to the overall backup offering, the interesting thing about Azure Backup is that we're fully integrated with the Azure service itself. So in addition, as you would expect, to being able to back up individual or sets of VMs in Azure, we can also back up VMs that are outside of Azure using the Azure Backup agents. In addition to that, we also have some integrated policies, things like multi-factor authentication, the reporting that we offer, as well as integrated access control with all of your existing groups that are within Azure today.
Cool. So can you like get me started? Like how do I set this stuff up?
Absolutely. Yeah. So we'll run through the first scenario, which is creating a recovery services vault and then applying it to a single VM. So in that case, it's very simple. You're basically choosing your target region where you're going to be deploying the services vault, and you're giving it a friendly name. Pretty straightforward. After that, what we can do is select the type of redundancy that we want. By default, Azure is going to select geo-redundant storage, and that's to ensure that your replication is happening across regions so that we're not at a single point of failure in a single data center, for instance. We also have locally redundant storage where you can have multiple backups of your VM, but it's within the same data center for use cases that maybe aren't as critical. The next area that we want to take a look at as far as configuration goes is the actual policy itself. So again, this is a policy that we're setting for this vault. In this case, we've selected to do a daily frequency with two snapshots. And you can see that we also have options for monthly recovery as well as annual recovery, just again, depending on your specific situation. So next up comes, how do we actually activate this on the VM, right? And the way that we do that is simply going into the VM, selecting backup, selecting the vault that we just created, and selecting the policy that we just created as well. Does that make sense so far, David?
Yeah, totally. I mean, the thing that I was just about to ask, and you answered it, was how do I remember to do this? Like it's not clear that I have a set that backup is going to run all on my VMs. What do I do to make sure that it always runs on my VMs? And I think this is the key to that, right?
It's a great question, right? I mean, obviously, we don't want to have this much overhead and individually backing up every VM that we create, especially as we move towards scale. And so what we also have is the ability to configure a policy based on resource groups and subscriptions that will automatically apply your backup policy to VMs that may not have it. So it's an additional safeguard, it's some automation to ensure that all of your VMs are backed up, or at least the subset that you want. You may have some individual test VMs that may not necessarily have the same need for recovery. And in that case, you can exclude those, as you see here in the screenshot.
Okay, so now I think I have a good idea of what that advisor recommendation is trying to tell me. I want to thank you, Travis, and I'd like to thank all of you for watching this. I hope you'll join me again here on the Advisor Clinic in the Azure Enablement Show.